Hi, this is Jaap.
And this is Kelvin.
So the Crystal has the highest resolution in consumer VR right now, which makes some people believe that if you have a 3070 GPU or a 3060, you cannot really use the Crystal. So we want to try those two GPUs today in DCS in VR.
Also, the Crystal has the built-in eye tracking where it only needs to render in full resolution at the place where you're looking at. With this, we can even run the DCS in VR with a 2060.
And also because the Crystal's clarity is so high, you even benefit from it even if you run the game at a lower resolution than the panels. You still get an image without any screen door effect, which is very crisp, bright and vivid. So we're using the 3060 GPU with the Crystal at 90Hz and 0.75 render quality. Without dynamic foveated rendering, we get around 25 FPS. But with DFR on, we almost triple that to around 70 FPS. DFR only renders sharp the area you're looking at, so if you wear the Crystal, you won't even really notice any difference whether DFR is on or off, except much higher FPS.
With 3070 GPU, we run the Crystal at 1.0 render quality. Without DFR, we get around 45 FPS. With DFR, we double that to the 90 FPS. Then last, let's try the 2060. We have to put the Crystal down to the 0.5 render quality and run it at 72Hz. With DFR, we get a good 55 to 60fps. Without DFR, the game is unplayable at around 5fps before it crashes.
We do want to make one comment. To get these results on a 2060, you do need a good CPU. So for full disclosure, we put all the PC specs in the description below. So can you run DCS in VR on a 3060, 3070 and even a 2060? Yes, you can, especially on a Pimax Crystal despite the high resolution because it has eye tracking and DFR.
Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please leave below.